Your shares pushing higher on the news, Austin. And why make this move into industrial?
Yeah, so excited to be here, and thanks for having me as part of this. I think it makes total sense as a market. You know, we're coming hot off the heels of a couple of major, you know, automotive launches with Volvo, now getting the product into production for the technology for these LiDAR systems, you know, and AI-related systems going into the market. And we can leverage that towards these industrial automation markets. You know, I mean, it's what, on the order of industrial automation, on the order of a $200 billion a year industry today. And this is a big foray into it for us. You know, so being able to have Caterpillar as the leading provider of and manufacturer of industrial equipment more broadly, selecting Luminar to partner with to make this happen as part of their next generation platform is something that just makes total sense as we expand beyond the auto market. But again, leveraging those same capabilities, technology, and products as what we've been making for the automotive market. And, you know, there's a huge amount of value to be created.
Now they're going to the Cat off-highway trucks, for example. But this doesn't in any way speak to a lack of commitment in the AV space. You still push ahead as hard as ever there.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, just this year alone, we're going to be seeing, 200, 300%, you know, growth in the automotive space for when it relates to our LiDAR production and shipments, you know, globally to these different automakers. So that's something that we're really excited about and pushing full speed ahead on to get those economies of scale and get that ramped up. But in parallel, it makes total sense of to be able to capitalize on markets like this as auto continues to be able to ramp up in order to be able to, I would say, have that same mission around safety and autonomy in a very high value add way. And of course, the ASPs and sales price that we're able to get in the industrial markets is actually a multiple for the same products and capabilities as what it is in the auto market. So it just makes sense.
And is that the average selling price? Is that because of a lack of competition? We just think at the moment the anxiety around your company, your stock, has been Chinese competition in particular. And when it comes to, for example, reporting that Mercedes is going with a Chinese competitor, are those sorts of narratives true?
Well, first of all, I think taking a step back a little bit, you can give China certainly credit for a lot of early adoption when it comes to, you know, the Chinese market and LiDAR market, where you now have, you know, what, on the order of a million vehicles being shipped, you know, with LiDAR and local providers. When it comes to a global standard and the capabilities and technology, Luminar is really second to none. And I think you pointed out maybe there was some confusion or misreporting earlier on some speculation when it comes to, you know, Chinese for some of the rest of the world. Luminar's partnerships with the global automakers is not only strong, but we're in the leading position when it comes to global automakers more broadly. And I think that's something that we're going to continue to capitalize on for the broader Western world, which represents about 90% of the volume and maybe even more of the value of the global automotive market. And I think even with, for example, in Mercedes in particular, I mean, things have been continuing to move full speed ahead, you know, since the original partnership that we've had with them, and actually even just signed up officially to be able to use Halo as kind of that next generation product that we kind of alluded to at earnings. So this is something that we're moving full speed ahead on. And by the way, the Halo is the next generation technology beyond what we're doing today. And that further allows us to standardize the product across these markets and industries.
So you have the Mercedes-Benz business when reporting was that Hesai had it. I'm interested that tariffs, you talked about production, how you're going to be scaling to more than 200% in terms of the amount of LiDAR you're going to be producing. But you produce over in Mexico as well. How is the current administration going to be affecting that?
Yeah, so there, I mean, there's a lot of different kinds of tariff considerations more broadly. And I would say in terms of all the different dynamics going on, Mexico is certainly one of those that's obviously a hot button topic. We have a portion of our content value that comes from Mexico currently that ships into the U.S. for the production, you know, in particular of the Volvo vehicles that are being produced in South Carolina. So what we're working through as part of our global supply chain, which Luminar is uniquely set up between Mexico, Thailand, you know, and also with a Taiwanese company, TPK, we actually have the ability to be able to shift around between our different partners at a global scale that whichever way the trade winds blow, we're able to have a truly global presence there. So so that's something that's going to be as part of a evolving production plan over the coming call it next few weeks to make sure that's in place. The only other thing I'll say is that when it comes to the tariffs for the vehicles themselves, we know that there's obviously new tariffs that are introduced today. But when it comes down to it, the vast majority of all the production that we have is going to U.S. vehicles now, so that's not really affected by this.